Hello. Hey, it's Jay, and I'm back with another video. Okay, this video is for the ladies and the ladies only. Because you guys, y'all already had y'all video, the shoe collection Carlos made for y'all. And if you a guy and you sitting here already watching, you watching this point, I'm gonna need you to go back, click that shoe collection video, give it a thumbs up and comment. And for my lady, I'm gonna need y'all to do the same on mine. Okay, because in this video, I am giving you guys a tutorial on my everyday go-to makeup look. Everything I use in this video is very affordable. It's from drugstore or Sephora, but like I said, it's very affordable. It's beginner friendly. I'm giving y'all the full details of everything, the products, the colors, the shades, how to, how not to, all that. So just stay tuned and watch the video. Bye. Hey you guys, I'm back. And I did my eyebrows off camera, as you guys can see. But to get started, I'm using my Afro Care as my moisturizer. This stuff is the truth, but you do not want to go overboard and use too much of this, because your face will look like you just ate a big pan of fried chicken, girl. Go ahead and pat that in your skin, just like I'm doing. Alright, next I'm going in with my Too Faced Cooling Primer. This is actually a product that I got for free from Sephora. It comes with your birthday little thing if you have enough award points. I'm just rubbing that into my face, you know, rubbing it in. This actually sometimes get a little like cloggy, like I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, just keep rubbing until it's all smooth. All right, now I'm going in with my Too Faced Born This Way foundation. I'm in the shade Spice Rum. I got this from Sephora for about $29. I really like this product. I've been obsessed with this product for about 3 years now. Like, it's so hydrating and it smells good and it's just full coverage. The coverage is full. I'm just using my Sephora foundation brush just to blend all of this out. This is a very easy step. You want to make sure you get every single part of your face. Don't leave any spots out because your makeup will look very uneven. It's just not cute, girl. It's not cute at all. He was irritating me and then he gave me a kiss. He's so cute. Anyway, just blend that out. Make sure it's even. Get that forehead, girl. You don't want to leave any spots out. That's why I'm shaking my head. Yep, just like that. Keep on going, girl. You got this. Okay, so now it's time to conceal, ladies. I am using my e.l.f. concealer and I'm using the LA Girl Pro concealer. I'm not sure what it's called, either or. Call it what you want. But you can get both of these products from a local beauty supply or Walmart. I'm not sure about the LA Girl concealer. I'm not sure about that. I know I got that from Beauty Supply, but I got the e.l.f. from Walmart. Both are very cheap. I think the e.l.f. is about $5, and I'm pretty sure the e.l.f. the LA Pro concealer is about $3 to $5. But you pretty much want to put that underneath your eyes to cover them bags, and you want to get the start of your nose, the outer side of your nose, if that makes sense. I don't know. Just continue to watch. I'll shut up and you'll get what I'm talking about. Okay, now I am taking this flat brush. I think that I got this brush set off of Amazon, but it's just a flat brush. I'm using that to blend out both shades of the concealer that I used. Very, very easy. It's just to make sure all your lines are straight, make sure everything is nice and clean.
just continue to do that. Watch the video and you'll see what I'm doing. Okay, this is my favorite part. It's blending. What you want to do is get you a beauty blender. It must be damp if you want this to be blended into your skin to look like silk, girl. I got my beauty blender from Sephora. This one was very expensive. This was, I think, like $10. But you can get a beauty blender from your local beauty supply for literally a dollar. They're not as good. I feel like the ones from the beauty supply are way too, like, hard. The ones from Sephora, they're very soft and they get the job done. To blend, you never want to spread. You never want to wipe. You want to tap that concealer into your skin, girl. You want to look like milk, like I said. You want to look like milk. It is silk. Just keep tapping. I'll give you a closer look to see how it should be blended in. It should look no lines, no harsh lines at all. It should just be skin. Just keep tapping. Just keep tapping. Be Simone voice. So next up, I'm contouring. To contour, you will need to get you a concealer that is two shades darker than you. This is to give your face that sculpted look. This is not like a required thing to do. This is something like, if you want to do it, like, you don't have to do this. And this could be very difficult at times. But I'm just using my angled brush that I use for my eyebrows, and I'm just using that to make a line down my nose, not in the middle, but like you can see. Yeah, you can see I'm using another shade because I don't think that LA Pro Girl was dark enough. This is another e.l.f. Full coverage concealer. I'm just taking that right down my nose. I'm gonna do that to both sides. After you are done making your lines, contouring your nose, you want to get a flat brush to give that line some shape. You don't want a harsh line going down in your nose. Like, that's not cute. So you just want to get a flat brush just to define that shape, just to, you know, smoothen it out. Now I'm taking an angled blending brush. I'm just gonna blend that up. I'm going upwards to blend it. As you can see, it's very easy. Very easy, just blend. I'm going back in with my e.l.f. concealer just to give it a more defined look. I don't think that the shaping was all the way there. You don't have to do this step, it's just what I prefer. I'm just doing the same thing. I'm just not going up to my eyebrows this time. I'm singing whatever song was playing. But yeah, just continue to watch. Do y'all see how snatched my nose is? Do you see it? It's snatched. This is how it's supposed to look. Just keep blending that out. I am snatched, okay? Alright, next you want to go back into your concealer shade, the shade that's lighter than you, and you want to go right down the center of your nose and get your nostrils. You don't have to get your nostrils like I do, but I just like my nose to look very defined, like I said. I'm going to go on my forehead, not your entire forehead, just right above your eyebrows to highlight And then I'm going in with that darker shade of my e.l.f. and I'm using that to contour. Going right down your cheekbone or whatever it's called. You see what I'm doing? You get the picture. Just to give you that sculpted look, like I said. Stroke it for me, stroke it baby, work it baby, work it baby. Alright, get those damp beauty blenders back out and you are about to blend every single thing that you have on your face. You want to tap, like I said, tap, tap, tap. Do not smear. It's not going to look pretty, girl. I'm trying to tell you. Don't smear it. To get those darker shades, you want to blend up. Don't blend down or you will look like you have a beard. Blend up. Go up. Don't go down. And tap, tap, tap. Dab, 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 like the Migos say. That was so corny. But yeah, like I said, just keep on doing all that. It's very easy. Sit at that. The fun step, just blending. And once you get it all complete, you should not have any harsh lines. You want everything to be perfectly blended into each other. Give it that nice ombre effect. Okay, right here I got that LA Girl Pro Concealer, the darker shade, and I'm just putting a little on my forehead because I felt like the highlights and my foundation color was not very, it wasn't blended well. It was too harsh, so I just drew an X and a line across to blend it. Blend that highlight and the contour out. Use my beauty blender just to dab it in. Now you can see it's a very smooth, clean look now. Clean up any harsh lines you see. Clean up any unblended things you see. Now I'm using my Black Radiance Translucent Powder to set in that highlight. Put a little bit in the lid. And I'm going to use a beauty blender, a dirty beauty blender. Let's see if I got a beauty. Nope, I got a clean one. It's not clean, but you know. Just dab it in there a little bit. Don't have too much. And you want to press it into your skin. Press it into that highlight. Press it in just like that. Now I'm using my Black Radiance True Complexion palette to basically set and bronze where I contoured at. I'm using the middle shade and I'm using a powder brush just to go everywhere where I contoured at. So now I'm using my Milani Make It Last setting spray. I'm using a beauty blender, spray that beauty blender and just dab into where you have put that setting powder at. It's like a double set. That's so lame to say. Just press it into that powder. I don't bake anymore. Baking is just like so 2013. Doing this helps you not have flashback. You will not get any flashback doing this. I promise you, you won't. So this is another one of my favorite parts, and I'm pretty sure this is any girl's favorite part. It's to highlight. I got this highlight from my mom. I actually took it from her like 3 years ago. I'm sorry if you're watching this. I'm pretty sure you know I have it, but yeah, I took this like a long time ago, and yeah, I just love it. I'm sorry if you're watching this, but yeah, I'm just using a fan brush to put it on my cheekbones, both sides, the tip of my nose, and the bridge of my nose. Yes, you're gonna be glowing when you highlight. Highlighting is just like the best part to do. So it's like it completes your face. Alright, get that setting spray that we used a little while back to set your face. Spray it down, girl. Make it wet, girl. Make it rain. Make it rain. But yeah, just fan it off. Let it dry however you want, air dry. I fan it. Make it go faster. Make the process go faster. It's just... Now I am putting on my mascara. That is Too Faced. Damn, girl. Mascara. It's just like the Better Than Sex foundation, in my opinion. I also got this free from Sephora with my birthday package. I'm pretty sure y'all know how to put on mascara. It's pretty much self-explanatory right here. Once you're all done with that, you want to grab your lashes and boom, put them babies on. I don't like to put my lashes on camera because it just takes too long. So now I'm using my lip liner and I'm going to line my lips. I got that from a beauty supply as well. Okay, so don't judge me with this, but this is a Too Faced lip injection gloss. Okay, you can use any clear gloss, but I love this gloss because it just makes your lips so plump. And I know you're probably wondering, like, girl, what the hell is you using this for? Your lips are big enough, but I just love it. I love and hate it because it just be burning too when you put it on. But this is a light pink gloss. I got this gloss from a friend of Carlos's. Her name is Asia. I will drop her at. She sells this gloss and it tastes so good and it smells so good and it just feels so good. Now I'm going in with this NYX gloss. I forget what the name is. I'm sorry, y'all. I'll figure it out and I'll put it in the description. Just put that on and then I'm gonna go on top of that with a clear gloss. Got my lips looking nice and I just want to dab off a little glossy to me. Not making matte, but just a little less shiny. That's not cute to me. I'm going back in to highlight a little bit because you can never highlight too much. If anybody ever told you that's too much highlight, they hate mad poke. Yeah, just that on it. Now that completes the video. I hope you guys liked it. This is what I do when I wear makeup. It's not like anything too much. It's not too less. It's just right. So if you guys like this video, just comment, like, and subscribe for me. Thank you guys. See you in the next video.